In the fall of 1963, a cat named Félicette blasted off in a rocket headed for space, her brain and body hooked up to a whole bunch of sensors. Little did she know, she was headed where no human had been before, on a mission to reveal how the brain works in near zero gravity. As far as early astronauts go, Félicette isn't an especially famous one. But in one 10-minute flight, she helped pave the way for all of the human explorers who would follow. The practice of sending living things to space was only about 16 years old when Félicette made her historic trip. US scientists kicked things off in 1947 with a bunch of fruit flies. Then in 1948, a rhesus monkey named Albert blasted off from New Mexico in the nose of a V-2 rocket. And in the coming years, the US and the Soviet Union sent dogs, rabbits, rats, and chimps, all sailing past the stratosphere. The point of sending up all these animal explorers was to get an idea how the human body might respond to space travel. The space race was in full swing, and the two countries were each scrambling to get humans into space before the other. So they had all sorts of questions about the effects of weightlessness, radiation exposure, and the breakneck acceleration that happens during launch and re-entry. But they weren't the only ones. France also wanted a piece of the space game, and they quickly became the third country to establish a space program. By 1959, French space scientists were fixated on understanding how weightlessness affects the body. They were especially interested in seeing how it might affect brain signaling, breathing, and heart rate. So they started out by launching a few rats into space, but they really wanted to take things a step further and run some tests on a bigger animal. So they turned to cats, because neuroscientists already understood the cat nervous system really well, and they'd be able to suss out anything unusual. In 1963, the French space program picked up 14 female cats from a pet dealer and started training them for space. Any cat they sent to space was going to need to handle the roaring engine, the spinning rocket, and the intense G-forces as calmly as possible. And they could only send up one cat at a time, so they were looking for the chillest one of the bunch. For 2 months, the researchers put each cat into a box for a couple hours a day, with launch sounds blasting through speakers. They also put the cats in a compression chamber and spun them in a centrifuge to mimic what they'd feel in an actual rocket. To be clear, this kind of research would not fly today, and for good reason, but animal research ethics in the 1960s were a smidge different. So after putting each cat through this ordeal, the researchers graded each one on its performance, but they didn't choose a winner just yet. A couple weeks ahead of the launch, the researchers put all the cats on a cargo plane headed to the launch site, deep in the Sahara Desert. Testing continued there, and finally, after one last round with the 8 best performers, a black and white cat named CC341 rose to the top of her class, and the researchers picked her to be the first feline astronaut. Of course, CC341 was no name for the world's first feline astronaut, so they eventually dubbed her Félicette. Before the big day, they surgically implanted a bunch of electrodes inside Félicette's brain that would measure her brain activity throughout the flight. They made sure to cover areas like the left associative cortex and the right hippocampus, which are tied to higher level reasoning in humans. You know, the kind of stuff that could be pretty important during a space flight. Then, after a bunch of intense rehearsals, researchers strapped Félicette inside the nose of the rocket and blasted her into space. The electrode data streamed back to Earth in real time as Félicette's rocket blazed through the sky. She stayed alert during liftoff, which is no surprise given how noisy and dramatic the ride must have been, and her capsule recorded forces of 9.5 Gs. That's almost 10 times the force of gravity on Earth. But by the time Félicette got close to zero gravity, she was super relaxed. She was breathing slowly, and the researchers found few variations in her activity. 3.5 minutes into her flight, her rocket reached its peak at 157 kilometers above the ground. That's when things got a little dicey. The capsule tossed and turned, and during re-entry, Félicette had some minor heart trouble. But as her capsule glided to a landing 10 minutes after takeoff, Félicette was hanging in there, and she emerged from the flight totally healthy. Aside from the minor heart trouble, the one other odd thing scientists noticed was that Félicette had dozed off a few times, likely because of the sensory deprivation. But overall, the fact that she didn't suffer from any major brain dysfunction was good news for space scientists. Of course, they couldn't be sure that human brains would respond the exact same way as a cat's, but it was a promising first step. Sadly though, space cats had a short legacy that both began and ended with Félicette. 6 days after her little jaunt, a rocket carrying a second cat blew up shortly after liftoff, and Félicette's successor died before ever reaching space. Soon after, the French acquired two larger rockets big enough to fit larger animals, so they moved on to using primate astronauts. As for Félicette, she ended up being euthanized months after her journey so that researchers could study her brain. She never got the fame of some of the other charismatic animals that went to space around that time, but in 2017, a Kickstarter campaign raised funds to put up a statue of her at the International Space University in Strasbourg. And Félicette deserves it. She helped us understand the risks and challenges that human astronauts would face when they made it to space a few years later. We owe her some real credit for helping make their journeys safer. So to help celebrate Félicette, SciShow has made a limited edition pin of France's feline astronaut, which you can order right now by heading over to complexly.store.